Today, there are nearly 2 million Americans living with limb loss, and those numbers continue to grow as wounded servicemen and women return home. After losing a leg to an injury or disease, it takes time to adjust to a prosthetic limb. But as Leslie Mouton shows us, a team of engineers and medical experts is widening the options for women.
21-year-old Alexandra Capellini is an active college senior. She's in flats on the sloping campus walkways, but loves the look of high heels.
Most of what women like to wear when you're going out or even adjusting to seasons.
Alexandra lost her leg above the right knee to bone cancer at age 7. Adjusting her prosthetic limb is second nature.
So there's a button here that I can press, and then my foot can flex this far.
Now Johns Hopkins University mechanical engineers and medical experts are designing a new foot for female amputees.
The highest prosthetics go currently is 0 to 2 inches, so we wanted to make one that could handle 0 to 4. So one of the biggest challenges we faced was having to mimic the ball of the foot. Whenever you stand in a high heel condition, it's a lot different than being on a flat foot condition because a lot of your weight gets shifted to the front of your foot, and your big toe is actually what keeps you from falling forward.
The foot holds position with an ankle lever. The goal, a quick adjustment so a woman could wear heels to a party and then kick them off to dance.
You don't get out a screwdriver to adjust your feet, usually when you change your shoes.
Alexandra loves the concept, but also the attention it brings to those living without limbs.
I think the bigger picture is emphasizing options for female amputees.
Leslie Mouton, KSAT 12 News.
Carbon fiber.